Hello from Chem Help ASAP. We're going to talk about vertical trends in the periodic table. So again, we're looking at just a snippet of the periodic table. We're going to focus on group number 7. These are the halogens. And if you notice on the screen, the electronegativity for these elements, fluorine is 4.0. And as we move down the periodic table, electronegativity decreases. So we go from 4.0 to 3.2 for chlorine, 3.0 for bromine, and 2.7 for iodine. Now, in a previous video, we saw that electronegativity increased as we went across from left to right on the periodic table. It decreases as we go down the periodic table. And what's interesting is that for all these elements, the effective nuclear charge is equal to 7. They're in group number 7, they have 7 valence electrons, and their effective nuclear charge equals 7. So this is not driven by a change in effective nuclear charge. It's really driven by the size of these atoms. So we're going to look at the van der Waals radius. Again, we're going to communicate these as the units of angstroms, which are 10 to the minus 10 meters. And fluorine has a van der Waals radius of about 1.47 angstroms. And then as we get to these larger elements, more periods, more shells, we actually get larger and larger atoms. So 1.75 for chlorine, 1.85 for bromine, and very close to 2 angstroms for iodine, 1.98. So let's look at this on the left. Here's our nucleus, so where all of our protons are, and we're going to have shells. Let's try to get 5 of them because we go all the way down to bromine. So this would be the first shell, second, third, fourth, fifth, and of course we have electrons in all these shells. So you can imagine, as the effective nuclear charge over on the right remains constant, the distance over which this effective nuclear charge is being exerted is getting larger and larger. And therefore, the net effect of the effective nuclear charge gets to be smaller. So what we see is electronegativity is both affected by the effective nuclear charge, which we know, as well as the distance over which that attraction is exerted. So for these, as we go down the periodic table, the effective nuclear charge is unchanged, but the distance increases, so our electronegativity decreases, and that is the classic vertical trend in the periodic table.